Hi, everybody. I'm Nicole Vulcan, editor of the Source Weekly, and why don't you introduce yourself?
Hi, everyone. I'm August Paul Johnson. I am 18 years old, and I've been living in Bend for 2 years now. I go to school here at OSU Cascades. I am now a freshman. I'm running for Bend City Council because of the foundation that our founding fathers built back in 1776. They believe that all citizens have the right to voice their opinions and get out there and make a difference in their community. So I believe that this is the best way for me to basically represent the young people in Bend, is to participate on the Bend City Council. Because I think that we don't really have much of a voice these days, but that me running, I will be able to herald that voice and give Bend City Council the vision of a future for young kids like myself.
Thanks. So we're going to cover a lot of ground today. We're starting off or doing these interviews in the midst of the pandemic. And in the over the course of the pandemic, there have been some, you know, demands and some just different expectations of the City Council. What's your view of how the City Council's role has changed during the pandemic?
I feel as though the City Council, they've changed in a way to where it's almost a passive aggressive. With the mandate for masks, they have put in basically a tax, or if you don't have your mask mandate on or wear your mask, then you can actually be fined once, twice, and then they do a three-time fine. And I don't exactly know how much it is, but I feel like that fine really isn't how Bend needs to operate. I feel like Bend, as a city, has to allow their people to kind of do what they want, but in a way that its citizens abide by the rules that our governor creates. Bend is a great place. I feel like I'm like super free here to ride my bike anywhere or go anywhere I need to be. And so for the Bend City Council to kind of push for that mask mandate, it almost to me was not necessarily a sign of hostility, but something close.
Thank you. What does leadership look like for a Bend City Councilor today?
Leadership to me for a Bend City Councilor today is someone who is willing to walk out or walk around Bend and just talk to citizens, be that personal one-on-one person, but also be knowledgeable in a way to where they can address issues or stand by points to better educate their citizens. I would like to see more participation with Bend citizens, with the Bend City Council, especially young people like myself. We have a lot of needs, a lot of wants, and I feel like focusing on younger kids is definitely the way to go for Bend. It's the future.
So what do you think the city's position on tourism should be as the pandemic continues into what looks like next year?
I feel as though the city needs to support tourism, but have a better educated premise on tourism, a way that you can tell tourists like the hazards or the dangers that COVID brings into our city, or tell them to be tested if they've been in a hot spot for COVID. But I believe that Bend City, the council, needs to embrace tourism. It's a way for Bend to get in capital and get more revenue for us to work on big projects like the transportation or childcare, such as that. I feel as though because Bend isn't a self-sustaining city and we get a lot of money from tourists through Mount Bachelor and just how great Bend looks, I feel as though Bend City Council needs to kind of help tourism.
So, of course, you just mentioned that, you know, tourism does bring quite a bit of money into the city. So as we're, you know, facing this pandemic, there's going to inevitably be economic consequences. What can be done at the local level to fuel Bend's economy in the recovery process?
I feel as though the Bend City Council needs to I guess, give more freedom to its businesses, whether that be through tax write-offs or just allowing the business to operate more on its own in a way to where they can change how their business works to better suit themselves for COVID, or change how they work to get more people to come into Bend and get the economy back up. I don't feel as though the city council has to reign over its businesses or take complete control to help economic growth. I feel as though economic growth comes with the freedom of being able to run your own business and run it how you like to run it.
Do you have a specific example of a restriction that's been put on a business that, anything constituents have told you, or residents, I guess, in this case?
I actually do not, off the top of my head. I would have to talk to, first off, my father. He knows quite a lot of business owners mm-hmm. and has talked to quite a lot of people. But I have talked to my father about this sort of thing. Mm-hmm. But with restrictions on businesses.
Yeah, I'm just curious if there's if the restrictions that you're identified are coming from the state level or the local level.
Mm-hmm.
That would be an interesting distinction based on the things that you said before that.
Yes, I'd have to look more into that.
So another thing on the ballot, in addition to your election, is the upcoming transportation bond. What's your position on the bond going forward this fall, as well as your view on the specifics of the bond?
I feel as though, I support the Bend, the transportation bond. I feel as though Bend does need to work more on its connections between East and West Side, and kind of making it so that we have better bikers or a better way of transportation. Whether that be walking, biking, skateboarding, driving. I definitely feel the need for safer roads. I bike all the time, and I find myself having to really get in the mode that I am actually a car, and I need to be extremely safe when going to work. One of the main specific things with the Bend bond, the Bend transportation bond, that I do enjoy is the overheads that will be put in to connect east and west, which I think is an amazing idea. We have in Bend this weird, cultural difference between West Side and East Side, and I feel as though to connect that through the transportation bond is the way to go.
So into that question was just a question of, do you agree with the timing of this bond coming on this this ballot?
It's a difficult question. I mean, due to COVID and our economy kind of slunking, it's hard to see what exactly needs to be done. I do think that this is a good time to get the transportation bond on and voted for, but maybe not necessarily going head first into it and having the city push for major changes automatically. I still feel as though businesses and people getting around town are adapting mm-hmm. to changes still. And mm-hmm. The city council needs to slowly go into that to help citizens.
Mm-hmm. What's your assessment of the city and city police handling of the recent ICE detainment situation, and also the events over this past weekend on Pilot Butte?
Mm-hmm. I believe that the Bend City Council, or the city's job, is to really allow the police to do their job by keeping law and order within the city. As a citizen, you have the right to do whatever you want, whether that be doing something illegal or infringing on someone else's rights. And I feel like the police's job is to make sure that those negative things actually don't happen. So with ICE especially, I feel like our police force did a pretty neutral job, definitely not bad. They didn't do anything wrong that would have put Bend City in the face of, I guess, scrutiny from either the federal government or our local government. I feel as though with ICE especially, that's Governor Kate Brown's job. Being ICE as federal officers, Kate Brown has more of the power to go head to head with the federal government. But as a Bend City, I feel like our police are doing a great job. They just need to stick to their jobs, keeping our citizens safe. And when rallies come up, standing by is definitely the way to go.
So that just has me thinking about the notion of defunding the police. What's your take on that situation as a whole? What it looks like in reality, or even if you agree with that?
I definitely don't agree with defunding the police. What I do feel like is that there are ways that we could, I guess, alter our police force or create more, like, or have better funded specialized units. So officers that aren't carrying a weapon, that work more with mental issues. Like if one of my friends was having a mental breakdown, I wouldn't want an officer with a gun to show up. So I feel like not defunding or looking into ways that the city council can, take cuts and put those cuts toward of money, put that money towards a more specialized Bend City police.
Mm-hmm. So another big topic in Bend is growth, which brings a lot of challenges to the table. What do you see as the top two challenges that face Bend in the regard of growth, and what would you propose to deal with those?
I feel like 90% of the other counselors would agree that the issues with growth is that our housing is expensive and our roads just need to get more safer. So to talk about housing, I'm a big guy for growth. I feel like Bend, as Bend grows, it gets stronger. And if I become a Bend City Councilor, I'm definitely going to push for growing Bend's East Urban Growth Boundary. I want to see more neighborhoods that have the Bend feel, where it's the single family housing, where you can grow up, raise your kids, and then your kids want to decide to also live in Bend. With growth also comes the transportation aspect, and that's why we have our transportation bill in place, allowing for more roundabouts to be placed in neighborhoods, and just for allowing a safer Bend for bikes as well.
Mm-hmm.
Growth is big, and I think it's very important to Bend.
So one of those that you mentioned is affordable housing. It's typically a hot topic of conversation during mm-hmm. campaigns for at least the last decade. And the problems are just, you know, the supply can't keep up with the demand. What actions would you take or would you support to address housing for low and middle income earners in Bend?
I mean, there's a lot of different ways to go at it, and each counselor has, I guess, their own take on it or their own vision. My personal thing is to allow Bend to grow, I guess, a neighborhood style, to have the single family houses and support those, but also to involve more of the affordable housing projects to come into place. We have one that's actually going on down in Southern, more towards the south of Bend, and it'll house a couple hundred people, and have that sort of density to allow it to be placed within a neighborhood. I think that sort of housing that is not necessarily a hotel, but is packed, sort of cubicle, is a great way to support Bend citizens. I have a couple friends actually living in those who actually work at Albertsons, and I believe that that sort of housing actually really does support the guy who maybe works at school, goes to his 9-to-5, and is really just trying to get by himself.
Mm-hmm. How does that jive with the stuff that you just mentioned about the single family home and sort of the American dream? How do we get all of that together? And how do we make it affordable for those lowest, you know, income earners?
Mm-hmm. I feel as though a good way to kind of, I guess, attack both is to allow builders, or I guess give tax incentives or tax write-offs to builders so that they have a better ability to get to Bend, get their building plans, and then get to work. One of the big things is that our building permits, the time it takes to get a building permit approved is so long, and I would love to see that shortened just a bit more so that they can put more buildings on the street. I feel as though also that the thing with the single family homes is what I believe Bend actually really encompasses is living here with your family. That the single family homes have their spot within Bend, especially towards the east. You'll see a lot of neighborhoods or neighborhood associations that protect those single family homes. But the ability for a builder to come in and have a quick permit or get building quickly to get those affordable housing or where I guess my friends live is also a really big push. So you could, the city definitely could split and work on both the single family or the, I guess, the multi packaged as well.
Mm-hmm. So do you feel like the city is doing enough to support diversity, equity, and inclusion? And if not, what would you do?
I feel like the city, is doing its job in supporting diversity, equity, and inclusion. I mean, it's not, well, the thing is that I don't really see the city as having to go that route. The city is supposed to work on their police, on funding their police, the firefighters, the sewers, land use, and so I feel the way that the city could work towards having a more, embracing feel of all of its citizens is talk more to its neighborhood associations, and see. You know, what kind of issues or problems that they have within their diverse citizens. There was one thing that Chris Piper brought up maybe a couple weeks ago, was that on building signs or building permit signs showing what was going to be built, there wasn't another second language for citizens to read. And I thought that that was a good first step to get to where we want to be as a whole, like family, you could say.
Okay, thank you. So, as we're talking about affordable housing, we'll jump back to that again.
Okay.
There's meanwhile hundreds of people living in different encampments, or out of their cars in Bend. Homelessness is one of the top issues of concern for Bend voters, yet the city council, has yet to
address it
really, you know, move forward with establishing an established camp. Mm-hmm. What would your plan be for addressing homelessness in Bend?
I have seen, or people have reached out to me with a couple different ideas that they want. The one thing that they want to steer against is calling it a camp and more as a village, which is more hospitable, I'd say, within Bend. So I don't really have any big ideas on homelessness, but what I would say is that some of our city councilors do. I believe Chris has a good idea where he's actually taking unused land that is owned by the city, and they're making these villages out of them to where homeless people can come in and then set up and, I guess, go on through their lives through that, which I think is a good start. We do have a lot of nonprofit organizations within town that do work with homeless people, and I feel as though one route is that the city could go in and communicate or talk to those nonprofits and group with them to see what the city can do to help those organizations.
Mm-hmm. So the city of Bend played a role in getting the Deschutes County Stabilization Center started. What do you think their ongoing role should be at, with the city helping participate in a county program?
I feel as though that's a good start to have the city support something bigger than itself. I would love to see other cities such as like Redmond, or the, I guess the cities within the county support that so Bend isn't doing all the work. I do think that by putting money into something that doesn't just work on the city itself, we do have to have some sort of progress with that, or else you're just funding something and you have a hole in your pocket for money. The city supporting something county-based, I do think, is a good idea, especially if it works with people in need.
Thank you. So as it stands right now, the city council is paid a small stipend. Do you believe that city council members, as well as people serving on various committees for the city, should be paid a living wage?
I don't think so. The city position is a volunteer position. My rival Anthony says that a lot. He's like, this, being on the city council is volunteer, nonpartisan as well. So being paid a livable wage, I guess it does allow the ability to put more of your energy towards being on the city, but you have to notice that the city councilors need to be citizens themselves and work the jobs that are based within the cities and get that feel of being a person within Bend. So giving a livable wage to someone who works at a volunteer position, it's not something I am down for.
So we're getting close to the end of our questions. Before we finish, I want to give you the opportunity to name one critique of the Bend City Council. Or a city council member, if you so choose.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm not going to throw anyone under the bus, but one thing I would critique about the city council is their ability to, I guess, not really work with young people within the city. That's something that I actually see a lot within government. Being in my government class in high school, we would talk about all these big things within big government, and I mean, it was always out there further away where we couldn't reach it as young people. It was something that older people would step up to get to, and I feel as though young people have amazing ideas. All they need is the help or the voice to get that, and I don't think that our city council and many around the U.S. really come to younger people and ask what they need help with or what they could see the city going towards. Mm-hmm. They are indeed the future of the city, and to not have that input really is kind of heartbreaking to me.
Is there anything that we haven't talked about yet today that you want to discuss or let people know about?
I mean, I would just like to say that young people need a voice in Bend, and another big thing that I push for in my campaign is to bring more entertainment or more facets of things you can do within Bend. As a young person, I mean, I could go to a party every weekend or go do drugs and kind of ruin my health instead of hanging out with friends at like the bowling alley or something like that. I would love to bring different options for young people to decide, hey, I want to do this day. With friends and kind of build that connection with their city instead of that connection with some substance.
Great. Anything else you want to add before we're done?
No, that's great.
Thanks for being here and thanks for taking part in the democratic process.
Thank you, Nicole.